Agriculture is big business in California, and over the last year, one of the industry's biggest expenses, fertilizer, has doubled in price.
Yeah, meteorologist Heather Waldman joining us right now. So, Heather, you talked with a researcher who has found a unique way to try to reduce that cost, right?
That's right. And the simplest way to save money on fertilizer is to use less of it. The challenge then is maintaining the same quantity and quality of crops, and that's where some pretty savvy science comes into play.
Agriculture is not growing plants. Agriculture is growing plants that produce grain, that produce fruits, that produce food.
To keep up with demands of a growing population, many farmers use expensive nitrogen-based fertilizer to boost productivity.
The problem is that more than half of whatever we are putting on the soil leaches out and goes to our water sources.
When that happens, drinking water can become contaminated, and excess nitrogen in soil releases powerful greenhouse gases.
That actually dissolves our ozone layer and then is a maximal contributor to global warming.
Dr. Eduardo Blumbald is a distinguished professor of plant science at UC Davis. He spent years modifying rice plants to take greater advantage of soil bacteria and rely less on synthetic fertilizer.
Yeah, the bacteria gets the nitrogen from the air, produces ammonium, the plant takes ammonium. If the plant takes ammonium produced by the bacteria, you have to put less nitrogen on the soil.
And so far, it's working.
This has very, very little nitrogen. So if you can put this amount of nitrogen, but have the bacteria doing the work, that's what you get.
He says these modifications cause no noticeable change to the rice grains themselves, so they're still nutritious. Blumfeld says that this work could have a positive impact on our water system, climate change, and farmers' wallets.
If we could provide only 10% of the nitrogen that the plant needs by doing this, farmers in the U.S. alone could be saving 10 to 15 billion dollars a year.
Blumwald says the next step is bringing in industry partners.
Soon, we hope, we are going to get the industry involved with that, bringing the seeds to the field, and then start measuring.
And Dr. Blumwald is hoping farmers will be able to grow this rice commercially within the next several years. The plan is to extend this technology to maize and wheat plants in the near future. Back to you.
And all that happening in our backyard. Cool to see that, Heather.